Dear students, I welcome you all to EPG Pathshala. Myself, Professor Sampath Kumar Swami, working as Professor at Department of Tourism Management at Indira Gandhi National Tribal University, Amarkantak, Madhya Pradesh. Today, you will be listening from me on a very important and contemporary topic, that is tourism paradigms. After completing this module, students will form an ideas on the prospective changes in the sphere of tourism and will be able to understand the importance of creativity and innovation in the fields of tourism and hospitality. Analyze the newer concepts of tourism development. Review the fresh patterns of tourism advancement. Introduction. A paradigm shift in totality has been ushered in the field of tourism due to several factors. Of course, globalization is the most crucial among them, while the impacts of globalization were more prominent in the manufacturing, automobile, consumer durables, food and beverages, and such tangible industries, tourism, regarded as the prime service industry too, was molded in a fashion so as to idealize the concept of global village. To elucidate the imperatives of the term paradigm, it entails the never standards or never ways of some aspect. Paradigm stands for the pattern of something. In tourism, it also constitutes refreshing models of progress. The explosive technological developments have scripted new paradigm, tourism paradigms at the global level. All the stakeholders have in the 21st century joined the cause towards making tourism a vibrant industry. The phenomenal change that happened in tourism can also be attributed to the information revolution. As a result, the modern tourist is well aware and incredibly responsive. The UN has declared 2017 as the International Year of Sustainable Tourism for Development that can make tourism an enamoring and enduring phenomenon that had sparked in the 80s and 90s. Yet, it gained profound traction of late. The slants of sustainable tourism development have strengthened the promotion of alternative tourism. The offshoots of alternative tourism, such as agrotourism, hydel tourism, eco-tourism, village tourism, vineyard tourism, health and wellness tourism, etc., received remarkable boost, were considered as the best remedy to the grave modern ailments like high pollution, global warming, depreciation of forest cover, poaching, leveling of farmlands, cultural erosion, corrosion, stress and tension, but wastage of natural resources. No other industry of global importance has evolved so profusely as tourism. Each and every component of tourism undergoes metamorphosis on a regular basis, in line with changes in the attitude, behavior, interest, taste and outlook of tourists. Whether travel, accommodation, cargo, designation management or the allied sectors, such as banking, insurance, entertainment, etc., have changed a great deal to cater to the requirement of the present day tourist. One of the most important paradigms is the specialties of the new tourism offerings. Even subtle common interests are marketed with a finesse that goes a long way in stimulating the tourist. For instance, tea tourism. The simple testing of tea in the natural habitats and the tea plantation and estates, tea trails are packaged as a spectacular attractions. The features of tourism paradigms are also lengthy, which itself indicates the range, efficacy and outstanding attributes of the same, and also the coyness attained. In the following sections, the most significant paradigms of tourism are discussed under various heads. Conservation paradigms. Tourists are now coming out in hordes to support noble causes like offering fresh life for once privating rivers. Voluntarism over the most recent concepts of tourism is central to such endeavors. Voluntary tourism or voluntary tourism is concerned with tourist interest involving or indulging in socially, culturally or environmentally uplifting activities. Without receiving any remuneration for those, such tourists tend to become proactive participants in the revamping welfare, educative, other welfare initiatives. The new paradigms of tourism spearheaded by the sustainable development campaigns and the ideals of responsible tourism gives great hopes to conservation of nature and natural resources like water, river crossing, river walks, eco trails, etc. are exciting activity highlighted in tour programs, which sensitize the tourists towards conservation of environmental resources. In Finland, spectacular tourism haven in Europe, the Lake Wellness Project is integrated with the tourism. Needless to point out, the relationship between tourism and environment is very solid. When natural resources are used for tourism purposes, there are different adverse effects too. At the same time, if resources like forest and water are promoted for tourism with a sustainable objective, the conservation efforts are bolstered up. Nowadays, in a lot of places, voluntarists are joining hands with the host community members in reviving rivers, nourishing lake beds, protecting jungles, and many other conservation ventures. The tourism importance of natural resources becomes the clarion call for the government and other stakeholders to rejuvenate them. It extends wholesome support to the project. Though environmental activities are objecting to some tourism projects as they are concerned about the futuristic ill effects, the sustainable attributes imbibed in the tourism initiatives make the local communities and environmentalists enthusiastic. Tourism thus can be mooted as a pivotal platform to take the green message to the masses. As tourism gains traction in the destinations, the activities that take life out of nature, like illegal sand mining, quarrying, and encroachments, will eventually worn out. The green protocol emphasized by tourism is turning out to be the backbone of conservation in vulnerable places. Go green has emerged as the motto of tourism now. Technology-driven paradigms. The pervasive influences of technological developments on tourism have affected a paradigm shift in all its functions. It will not be an exaggeration to point out that tourism operations are growing from strength to strength owing to the adoption of ICT. The internet has brought information pertaining to destinations at the fingertips of tourists and promoters. It has also enriched tremendously the awareness level of tourists. They have an array of options to choose, from airlines to hotels. Every key information lucidly provided through various tourism websites and portals enables the tourist to make decisions that satisfy their desires. The global distribution network such as Amadeus, Galileo and Sabre have transformed the process involved in tourism, including ticket booking and cancellation. The terminals display various sectors, price range, seating arrangements, customized options, offers and discounts, and alternative choices. Global positioning system and geographical information system, GIS, has made traveling to the nook and corner of the world a very smooth exercise. Further, GIS portrays the extent of ecological hazards in the destination, whereby the planners can take appropriate action in regulating and controlling tourism. Coaches and cars are more GPS enabled to serve the tourist, which aid tourist a great deal in reaching even remote tourist spots. It also helps tourists who are keen on self-driving to reach tourism centers. The advent of online travel portals such as Make My Trip, Yatra, Go Ibibo, Travelocity and Travel Guru took the industry to greater heights. Customization becomes never like before. Efficiency is also fabulous. Tourists are able to choose from the immense options presented to them on a platter by the OTP. Tailor-made packages gradually distinguished itself at the order of the day. Furthermore, the travel and hospitality rating sites like TripAdvisor and Expedia are serving the tourists mainly to determine the best operating properties and to opt the services of their preferences. Softwares like IDS enables the customer to have a view of the hotel rooms and take appropriate decisions. The room size, furniture, and other amenities can be gauged by the customers. They can also fulfill the choices concerned with the beach-facing resort rooms, swimming pool, golf courses, and all the indoor and outdoor aspects. Virtual tourism has a significant role to play other than being a vital marketing tool. It is actually doing a human service to tourists who are physically challenged and incapacitated to visit their destinations. Senior citizens and economically backward section of the society are also benefited by a way of virtual tourism. Various tourism sites such as Great Barrier Reef, Australia, and Mysore Palace, Mysore in India, have extended the facility of virtual tourism. The facility provided virtual tours to an interested lot in the comforts of their homes and views all the charms of the destination, understand its uniqueness, and get enchanted by artifacts and tourism products. The images mostly are of high quality and projected through 3D in many cases. Transport technology has undergone a paradigm change. Multi-axle tourist coaches are ruling the roads. They provide excellent comfort and safety to the tourist. Royal Caribbean, Queen Victoria, Star Cruise Company offer luxurious cruises that inaugurate the tourist state-of-the-art tourist trains are of great excitement to tourists. In India, the most famous tourist trains are Palace and Wheels, managed by Rajasthan Tourism Development Corporation. The Deccan Odyssey, run by Maharashtra Tourism Development Corporation, and the Southern Splendor, apart from the fast-moving trains running long distances such as Rajdhani Express, Shatabdi Express. Aviation too has created a sparkling image by dishing out quality first class, business class, and executive class services for passengers in the most modern carrier. In flight service, employs multimedia tools to entertain the passengers. F&B services have been enhanced in almost all the international carriers. Hospitality paradigms, the accommodation sector is witnessing mind-boggling transformation that leverages tourism industry to a very great extent. The paradigm extraordinary in this sector is that the offerings of hospitality itself have become tourism attractions. There are several examples to substantiate these eco-hotels. The eco-friendly hotels is a classic case in point. Eco-hotels like the Orchid, Mumbai, and the Rain Tree, Chennai, are drawing tourists in hordes. Eco-hotels actually glorifies the conservation paradigm by incepting the equipment and gadgets scientifically engineered to conserve water abundance of chemicals, prevention of power wastage, and the like. Further, houseboats are becoming centers of conferences and the avenues for staging cultural expressions. Houseboats like the Palace Place on Waves have excellent world-class conference facilities. Houseboats are also venues for screening the performing art forms. These facilities give fillip to MICE tourism and also entertain the tourist. Conducting the conferences in an ambience in sync with nature and utmost mobile is quite exciting for a tourist. Tourism projects like tree huts, homestays, agro enterprises, etc. not only offer the finest hospitality but also thrills the tourist abundantly. Boutique hotels is a luxury personified. It is being promoted as hotels with the point of view. The classic features of boutique hotels are scintillating. Heritage hotels are still dazzling. More heritage properties like ports, palaces, traditional buildings, heritage structures, havelis, etc. are being transformed into hotels. This way, the heritage properties are prevented from destruction. Hill resorts, beach resorts are here to stay, but eco resorts are very innovative. Experiential paradigms. One of the foremost paradigm to be highlighted as regards tourism are the experiential paradigm. Tourism in the present day is not merely an industry for sightseeing, and tourists are no longer want to be mute spectators at the detonation. The participative character of tourism is gaining momentum at a swift pace. Tourists want to experience the offerings of the tourism centers. They get excited involving themselves in bullock cart riding, flying kites, safaris, desert elephants, camel, etc., rowing, playing traditional games like pentagon, kutiyam, kulam, wearing masks, weaving, indulging in local food, drink pottery, trying their hands in handicraft making, etc. Alternative tourism forms, namely farm tourism, gastronomic tourism, rural tourism, and ecotourism, provide ample avenues in this regard. A stay in a rustic village in an idyllic ambience away from the hustle and bustle of city life is certainly deemed as dream visitation. tourism projects and its components, innovation and creativity. Tourism is undergoing a transition in consonance with the progressive projects and its enlivening components. Every destination wants to compete with its counterparts by establishing unique projects. Many newer and refreshing tourism projects have been unveiled recently, like the IMAX theaters, amphitheaters, golf courses, underwater aquarium, 5D theaters, theme parks, shopping malls, go-karting centers, snow domes, family entertainment centers, oceanarium, food courts, spas, health and wellness resorts, sculptures, gardens, eco resorts, view towers, etc. That apart, there are various facilities incepted in tourism products and destinations. The historical monuments have been made more interesting by introducing the sound and light show. Similarly, the eco destination has set up interpretation centers that have hugely impacted ecotourists. Excellent equipments are now given to adventure tourists for snorkeling, scuba diving, and other land air water-based activities. Moreover, shopping festivals and film festivals are primarily targeting the tourist. Marketing and branding paradigms. This aspect is very significant in the present scenario of staff competition in the field of tourism. Moreover, the challenge of off-season can pull back tourists in flocks. Monsoon tourism as an ideal train has put tourism in top gear by offsetting the challenges posed by lean season during the rainy period. The events organized during rainy season are being acknowledged as the off-season strategies in the realm of tourism marketing. Customer relationship management, CRM, and services marketing has advanced a great deal. Tourism promoters are coming up with excellent marketing strategies for customer acquisition and customer retention. The offers and incentives and privileges extended to frequent customers are fueling the CRM initiative. Destination branding is now witnessing marvelous changes. The positioning and packaging strategy have scaled new peaks. Dedicated advertising agencies are increasingly engaged in devising the marketing campaign. Good and effective public relations, PR, is creating a favorable image for world-class tourism destinations. Promotional slogans signify the tourism brand. For example, the 100% New Zealand campaign has become very popular. Destinations are highlighting their unique selling propositions as the hallmarks for wooing tourist. Events are also extensively used to woo the tourist. Some examples in their regard are International Yoga Festival, Olympics, and Rio Carnival. As part of the branding, obtaining various accreditations and recognitions of tourism products and organizations in an ongoing exercise. Safety and security paradigms. The repercussions of tourism are criticized strongly by some sections that comprise social and environmental activities, orthodox governments, crime prevention bureaus, historians, cultural enthusiasts, etc. Tourism developers and various levels have set up high standards for maintaining safety, maintaining security in the places of tourist interest. CCTV cameras are installed in sensitive and dangerous locations. Tourism police is being deployed at various destinations to ensure the safety of tourists and also to guide them properly on the do's and do nots. In beach destinations, trained lifeguards are stationed to take care of tourists indulging in swimming and also to prevent hawking and theft. Authorized guides are given adequate training not only to disseminate the information pertaining to destinations but also to give counsel on the interval course and observations. Ambulances with extensive facilities are operating 24 hours to ensure the safety of tourists. Highways police is on the prowl to prevent atrocities. On the major roads, descriptive signages indicate the routes and distances and also provide information on the aspects to be taken into account by the tourist indulging, including the warnings. Health and wellness centers are under the scanner for exploiting the tourist. The functioning of such centers, including the Ayurvedic massage centers, are streamlined by giving accreditations and licenses only after fulfilling the prescribed criteria. They are constantly under vigil, and even the slightest deviation results in withdrawal or suspension of licenses. For courts, restaurants and caves are places of tourist evidence doubt on the hygienic and quality related operations. Regular monitoring and evaluation has been initiated by the destination managers to ensure that quality food items are served to tourists in a hygienic environment. Some destinations regulate atrocities on tourists by legislative maneuvers. Demography paradigms. Designations are now thronged by women travelers. Destinations are now thronged by women travelers, some sole and some exclusive groups. Backpackers are increasing day by day. Professionals mostly are resorting to weekend travel. They are also active tourists as regards MICE. Honeymoon tourists are one prominent market segment. Currently, long-haul travel is now preferred even by families. Senior citizens and accessible tourists are now induced to travel owing to the facilities inserted in the tourist spots. Political paradigms. Countries in any political region are forming alliances as tourist circuits to intensify tourism promotion. This will foster cooperative and complementary marketing strategies. Memorandum of understandings and memorandum of agreements are being signed between countries to promote technology transfer, sharing of know-how, expertise and infrastructure, also facilitate movement of tourists. The promising paradigms. From e-tourism, there is a slant towards mobile tourism. Mobile technologies and applications are even more simplifying tourism processes, propositions and practices. Medical tourism is flourishing now as an organized phenomena. The roles of stakeholders are being defined. Responsible tourism initiatives are receiving special grants and fiscal aids. Tourists are also supporting the responsible tourism ventures. GPS navigators have revolutionized the travel sector. iTravel, devising specially made glasses for more effective enjoyment of tourism resources, is getting acceptance. Foreign travel cards is a preferred way of carrying cyber cash. It is more secure to travel more secure too. Travel insurance is becoming mandatory. Travel involves lots of risk which are uncertain, and insurance schemes such as overseas travel insurance are beneficial to tourists. Indian Railways too has dished out such an offer for its passengers. E-visa is a strong measure to reduce barriers in terms of travel formalities. Spectacular promotional strategies like roadshows, travel marts are receiving worldwide attention. Tourism is now taking place in new terrains like yacht tourism in Rotia, coral tourism in Cook Islands, sand dune tourism in Aruta, desert, Australia and timeshare vacations in the Caribbean. Recreation vehicle is becoming a standardized tourism practice. Corporate social responsibility is steadily becoming a philanthropic endeavor to reckon with. As part of CSR initiatives, tour operators are adopting destinations. Multinational companies are sponsoring the upkeep of monuments. Governments are lying to thrust on upgradation of airports and introduction of more sectors. Pro-for tourism is employed as vital instrument to increase fiscal benefits to the poor. People, community-based tourism is adopted by majority of the premier tourism destinations across the globe. Tourism is used extensively and on incentive for heritage preservation. The role of NGOs and consultants in promoting and regulating travel is quite promising. Area inclusive and sustainable economic growth, social inclusiveness, employment and poverty reduction, resource efficiency, environmental protection and climate change, cultural values, diversity and heritage, mutual understanding, peace and security. The UNWTO has incepted the International Network of Sustained Tourism Observations to monitor and ensure sustainable practices of the tourism sector. It will focus on evidence-based decision-making and timely measurement and management of resources and activities, each indispensable factors of sustainable tourism development. The concept of sustainability is currently inextricably linked to tourism planning. There are development and promotion of SMEs in the support in the tourism supply chains. Capacity building ventures are increasing. For example, capacity development for youth and women in tourism. Environmental auditing and environmental impact assessments are now mandatory for tourism projects. A strong link is developing between cultural heritage and creative tourism. Through creative industries such as architecture, design, arts, technology, and science, cultural heritage is brought back to life. It also contributes to sustainable tourism development. Tourism is now strongly supporting human rights and democratic movements. Proper tourism enhances quality of living index. Tourism promotes environmentally responsible marketing. Green marketing is the in thing. Green certifications are offered. For example, the green palm. Scientific knowledge of visitor impact is given more stress. Familiarization tours or farm tours are extensively extended for tour operators and travel journalists. Social networking, media including Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, etc. are making potential tourists more aware of the various features and practices of tourism destinations. What else can excite the newest tourist falling into the rapids in the Zambezi River, tracking gorillas in Uganda, chilling in Antarctica, exploring Transnistria, an unknown destination, safe and seamless travel is rated highly. Crisis management task forces are set up in major destination. Pink tourism and LGBT tourism are approved by UNWTO. Travel blogs are gaining prominence. There are scores of followers and many turn out to be prospective tourists. Heritage walks and self-guided tours are incepted around monuments and historical sites. Summary. The pathbreakers of tourism in the 21st century and the promising attributes of tourism have been discussed at length in the above sections. The paradigm of tourism are ever-evolving. The macro-environmental influences are at the crux of the paradigm shift occurring in the sphere of tourism. The tourism industry is also sensitive to the paradigm shift. The necessities coupled with changing motivational dynamics of tourists prompts the industry to adopt the transitions. The characteristics of the paradigms in tourism are very different, as seen earlier, like technology, driver, conservation, demographics, safety and security, political, hospitality, experiential innovation, and creativity and marketing and branding. Yet, the goals are the same, such as tourist delight and destination development. These focus areas are very crucial in the coming days. The key question that crops up now is whether tourism can flourish without compromises. The answer is an emphatic yes. The driving force behind this is, of course, the ideals sustainable development. The mechanism to regulate tourism growth in a sustainable manner are in place, and it is the prime responsibility of the tourism organizations led by UNWTO to take it further by continuing research, planning, monitoring, and evaluation. Tourism is here to stay with more vitality. The paradigm is to decide how the industry is going to stay. Dear students, all those paradigms or trends must have helped you to understand how the tourism will become in the future. With this, I conclude this presentation, and many, many thanks to all of you.